Hi, my dear friends. Today topic is LSMW. LSMW. What is mean by LSMW? Concentrate here. What is mean by LSMW? LSMW Legacy System Migration Workbench. My question is, what is mean by Legacy System Migration Workbench? Legacy System Migration Workbench means to upload the master data legacy system to SAP system. Listen once again. How LSMW is used? LSMW is a SAP tool that support when you copy the master data from non-SAP system to SAP. Let us understand here. Types of data. We have three types of data. One is master data, transactional data, and configuration data. So what is mean by master data? Master data nothing but vendor creation, customer creation, GL creation, and asset creation, and etc. So here, the LSMW is used for upload the master data from legacy system to SAP system. Concentrate here. For example, I need to create vendor master to upload vendor master through use LSMW. Concentrate here. Here I can add one note here. When I want to create only one vendor, I can use T code, either FK01, either XK01, like so on. Concentrate here. When I want to create single vendor, I can create based on the situation. I can create go T code. This is the T code actually. When I want to create the vendor based on the situation, I can go through FK01, I can go through XK01. So why this LSMW is required now? When I want to create single vendor, I can use this T code. When I want to upload multiple vendors, it may be 1000 vendor, 2000 vendors, 10,000 vendors, multiple vendor activities means multiple vendor master activities upload at a time. That time I can use LSMW. Listen once again, concentrate here. Multiple master data uploads from legacy system to SAP system. That time I can use LSMW. Okay. So LSMW is only upload the master data from legacy system to SAP system. Let us understand. What is meant by transactional data? Transactional data nothing but accounting entries. See, this accounting entries, when I upload legacy system to SAP system, I can use BDC, like so on. Okay. And what is meant by configurational data? Configurational data means whatever activities you are doing SPRO screen, that activities is called configurational data. Okay, master data, transactional data, and configurational data. Master data nothing but vendors, customers, GLs, assets, so on. And the transactional data nothing but accounting entries. Configurational data nothing but activities of SPRO screen. So now my task is LSMW. LSMW, it is used for upload the master data. Concentrate here. Now my task is to upload the vendors. When I create single vendor, I can use FK01 and XK01. When I want to upload multiple vendors at a time, that time I can use LSMW. Legacy System Migration workbench. Let us go to SAP. Here you can enter LSMW. Then click on here. Press enter button in the keyboard. See this one. Here also SAP has explained what is meant by LSMW. Welcome to the legacy system migration workbench. The LSM workbench is a SAP tool that is support you when copy data from non-SAP system. Okay, click on here. Okay, so this is showing already I created previously something. Now it is showing. Now my task is to create the vendors. Concentrate here. So project, subproject and object. So what is my project? To upload the master data, especially vendor masters. Okay, let us understand. I'm creating my own. These three things, you just give any names, whatever name you want based on situation, you just give it here, any names here. For example, my project is master data upload. Then click on here, this one. What is this? Create entry. Don't click on execute right now. Okay, first you can click on create entry. Let's understand. Master data upload. Then click on here. Okay, then it is asking sub project and description. Vendor master. Vendor master upload. Then again click on here, create object. Again vendor master create. Upload. Now click on here. Okay, let us see here. Now it can be changed. Now click on here, execute. First you can create entries, then you just click on here, continue or execute. Okay, then click on here, execute. See here, lot of options is available. First one, maintain objective attributes. You just double click on maintain objective attributes. See this one, concentrate here. Objective types and import method. This is the interview question. How many types of import method in LSMW? They have four methods. One is standard batch direct input and batch input record and BAPI and IDOC. So this is the four methods available into the LSMW. Basically this is the interview questions. How many methods or how many objective types available in LSMW? We have four types of methods or four types of objective available in SAP, in LSMW. One is batch direct input and batch input records and BAPI means business objective method, and IDOC, intermediate document. This is the four method you need to create. Now I am showing batch input records. Basically 95% of functional consultants, concentrate here, 95% of functional consultants used for batch input records. Okay, no problems. So you can use direct input, BAPI, IDOC, whatever you can use, you can use. But 95% of functional consultant used for batch input record only. So I am showing this method and concentrate and understand. So what I did, straight away double click on here, click on here display and changes. You keep it on note here. You can go any option. You can go any option. First you need to click on display and changes. Okay, click on your display and changes, then it should be activate. So what method I want to use? I am showing method of batch input records. Then click on your record overview. Record overview. Click on your record overview. Then click on your create. Enter your any 4-digit. For example, vendor record, right? Vendor upload. Vendor master upload. Here owner, SAP user. This is iDoc system, SAP user. And click on here, OK. Listen here, concentrate here. When I want to upload GLs, I can use here FS00. When I want to upload asset, here I need to enter AS01. When I want, same way, when I want to upload vendors, either I can use FK01 or XK01 based on situation. So now I am using here FK01. When I enter FK01, click on here OK to capture the fields. Listen careful. Wherever you want to enter the information, means whichever field you are using here, that fields are recorded. Okay, for example, my company code is FM01. My company code is FM01. Accounts group FMDV. Then click on your enter. What is the name? Name is vendor name is J and Co. And country India. Post box number 500018 and postal code 500018. Same thing, 500018. Example I am showing. So which field you need to record, so there you need to enter the information. When you enter the information, that field is go to recorded. Okay, so click on here enter, press enter button in the keyboard, enter. Again enter. So this field is not, I don't want to record this field, so you don't, I am not entering any information here. Enter here recon account, domestic vendor, short key 001, cash management group A1. Again press enter. Payment term 0001. 0001 means it is immediately. Then click on again enter. Enter and save. So when I click on save, this will be displayed. Here you need to click on display all. So what I said, wherever you enter the inputs, that field should be recorded. Let us see here. I recorded company code, vendor group, and name, post box number, postal code, PO, and country. Go down and go down. Let us understand. Recon account and short key, planning group and terms of payment. See this one, wherever I entered the information, that field recorded. Okay, do one thing, press control A, selected, this is the technical name and this is the functional name. You select technical name and functional name. Control C, go to Excel, do one thing, open new Excel, click on here, Control V, paste. So what happened? This is the information I pasted, and again go down, again press Control Y, select, Control C and pasted here, Control V. So now remove this empty one, delete, and remove this empty one, delete, and remove this empty one, delete, and again remove this empty one, delete. Concentrate here. Now selected these things, starting, go to data menu, select here text to columns. Okay, click on your text to columns, select here fixed width, next, here you can adjust, then next, finish. See this one. So this is the technical name and this is the functional name. This is the technical name and this is the functional name. So this is the information I don't want, just delete. Do one thing, click on your merge. So I don't want, for your understanding purpose I am showing. So again click on your select all, Control C, copy, go to second page, go to paste options, select here transpose. Click on here transpose. See here, the first page vertical, this is the horizontal. See this one. So here you can fill the data. Whatever vendors you want to upload, that vendor information you can enter here. Okay, for example here, what is my company code? FM01. What is vendor accounts group? FMDV. Ido see here, I showed here FM01, FMDV. And what is the name of the vendor? K and Co. Example, K and Co. Post box number, enter here any post box number. And 500018. K and Co means vendor name. 500018 and 500018 and country key India. And recon account 15000000, short key 001001. When I enter the 0, 0 will not comes right now. So first you can enter hash key, First you can enter this hash key, then you can enter type 0, 0001. Directly when you enter the 0, the Excel will not taken. That is the reason. First you can enter the hash key, then you can enter the zeros, then enter. See now, planning group A1, payment term. See this one, go to SAP. In case of any doubts, see this one, go down, planning group also 0001. Even go up, see short key 001, short key is the 001, terms of payment is 0001. See here I am entering my own way. You can enter your own way. This Excel will be fulfill the client. This format you can send to the client. Client will be given the all the details. Then this format you need to upload into the SAP. Okay. Hash 0001 like this. So again company code. I'm copy paste here. How many? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, FM 01. I'm preparing one Excel sheet here, and K1 and co name, K2 and co, and K3 and co, K4 and co, K5 and co, K6. What is meant by K5? This is the name, vendor name. For example, my vendor name is K6 and co. Whatever vendor name you want, you can write it. And co, my vendor name is Ravi, and AS and co, whatever vendor name you want to write it here. Then VS and co, like this you need to enter any information. Now post box numbers, copy paste here, and the same thing, now country India, copy paste here. Okay, then you can copy paste this thing also, control C and paste this thing also, control C, control V, control C, control V. What happened here? Here I prepared one Excel sheet. So when I click on your 3 tab, it goes to the hyperlink, no problem. So you can save it, select all, first remove, click on your this one, all are goes, and delete these headings. You don't want keep it headings, you can delete the headings, delete and remove these spaces, double click, adjust the space, double click. You don't want to keep the space. Why? Because when you keep this space, this is throw out the error at the time of uploadings. Double click. See this one? So this is the format I need to upload it into SAP. Upload it into SAP. Now go back to SAP, save and back. So here you just click on here, then click on your details. So that is comes here, VNUF, vendor master upload, then save and back. See this one. Automatically your selection goes next option. So double click on this. Click on your first, you can click on display and changes, then create, enter here any 4 to 5 digit, VNCR1 means vendor creation, vendor master creation. You just add one source structure name. For example, my source structure name is VNCR1, and for example, VECR1, whatever you want, you can put it. Then click on your OK. Then save and back. That's it. You don't want to, you can create one structure name, source structure name. Save and see this one, VECR1. Keep it on your mind, VECR1. Save and back. Again, see here, this is maintain source field. Click on, don't, before going to execute, first click on your objective overview. Click on your objective overview. Click on your list. Then go down. See this one? This is the fields I selected. This is the technical name. This is the functional name, character, and the length. Okay. Don't select table name and T code. You can select from the company code. First, second, you don't want to select table name and transaction code. You don't want to select. You can select from here. Do one thing. Press Ctrl Y, copy, Ctrl C, paste into Excel. Go to this one, paste into Excel, and go to SAP. Again, Ctrl Y, select technical names, Ctrl C, and Ctrl V. Okay, and char means better, you can enter C. C means character. C. Okay, now you can select the length. Ctrl Y. Don't select first two things, select from here, Ctrl V, Ctrl C, and Ctrl V. See, this is the technical name, this is the functional name, and this is the character, and this is the length. Okay, this length will be provided by, automatically provided by SAP. That is the reason I can paste it from here. Why I want to selected from here, I will tell you. Okay, so select here and go back. Now just click on here, execute. Okay, select maintain source field. First go to objective overview, select the table names, table fields. Now select here, click on here, execute. So click on here, select, and display changes. Click on here, this one. What is this? Table maintenance. This is the table. Click on here, table maintenance. See this one? Field name, technical field name. Select your technical field name, Ctrl C and Ctrl V. And type means character, Ctrl C and Ctrl V. And the length, this is the length, Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Ctrl C and Ctrl V. See this one? This functional name will comes automatically. Okay, technical name, and C means character, and this is the length. Press enter button in the keyboard. See this one? The functional name will come automatically. Now save and back. See this one? This is the source field, this is the table. Save and back. Again, maintain source relation, maintain source relation. This goes, means this is selection, next one automatically, it means it is goes correct way. Now click on your execute. It is automatically selected. VCCR1, once again select here, click on your display changes. First delete relation and select, click on your relationship. It will be assigned automatically. Now save and back. Save and back. Again, maintain field mapping. See, this is very, this is very very big video, so you can please concentrate and listen careful. Okay, every field is very important. So it selected next one, click on your execute. This is will open here, select here VNUP, then click on your display changes, concentrate here. Now go to extras, click on your auto field mapping. Click on your auto field mapping. Means this is the technical, company code, this is the technical name, this is the functional name. We need to map the fields. That is the reason. Go to extras, click on your auto field mapping. So this is, you just keep it as it is, then click on your OK. Don't change any radio button, click on your OK. Accept proposal, click on your accept proposal, click on press OK, OK, accept, 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 then OK. See this one, this is the technical name, this is the functional name, we are assigned mapping. This is the source, this is the rule, and this is the code. Code means nothing but backend ABAPR code. Okay, like that we are mapped the fields. Then save and back. Save and back. So this is the step 6th step. Sixth step you don't want. Don't enter any information. Basically that step is not required right now, so don't go. Select here specify file. Before going to specify file, go to Excel. So this is the format I need to upload it into SAP. That is the reason. So first of all, I am deleting this sheet. Delete, I don't want this sheet right now. So this is the information I want to upload it into SAP. So go to radio button, click on your save as. Means this is the information we need to save in text format, notepad format. Okay, wait, it's going to browse, please wait. So I'm saving in desktop. My file name is vendor 123. Here save as, select here, very important, select here tab delimited, text tab delimited. Means this is the Excel we want to save in notepad format. That notepad format we need to upload it into SAP. So click on here save. Okay, and okay. So remove this Excel, don't keep it here, just remove. Go to here, what is my one? Vendor 123, this is the one, vendor 123. This is the document I saved from the Excel. So open once for your understanding. Details, see this one, this is the company code, group name, and this is the post box number, country key, recon account, shard key, blah blah blah, XYZ. In case you need to adjust, you can adjust also. In case you want to adjust anything, you can adjust also, no problem. Okay, example I'm showing. Okay, in case you want to adjust anything, you can adjust, but don't change the format. Okay, go to file and save. And this is the file I need to upload it into SAP. Now go to SAP, double click on your specify file, execute, select legacy data. Don't select other thing, this is the very important. Don't select legacy data R/3, select legacy data on the PC. Select legacy data on the PC, click on your display changes. Basically here when I select your legacy data, all the people click on your file upload. Don't go there. Okay, first select the legacy data on the PC, click on your add entry. Here I need to upload the file. What is the file? My file name is vendor123. This is the one, vendor123, and give it here any name. When upload, and select here tabular, this is very important. Then click on here OK, then save. See, noted this error. Note it down, this error. Note it down. File name converter data. Convert data. So this one, this is the one. Converter data. Maximum 45 characters. So this is the name actually. Convert data. This is the name. This name you don't exceed 45 characters. So you just minimize this name. So double click on this name, like reducing the characters. For example, I'm reducing something. Then click on here OK, then save. See this one, data was saved. This is the error actually. This name don't exceed 45 characters. Click on go back. See, assign file, click on your execute and select, edit means delete assignment, and assign and save. Go back again, read data, double click on read data. So remove this tick marks, click on your execute straight away. See how many line items you are uploading right now. 10 line items. Minimize, double click on vendor 123. How many line items? Just 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, means we are uploading 10 line items. When it is shows 10, it is correct. Then go back, display read data, click on your execute, then straight away execute, continue. See this one, 1 2 3, this is the data we are uploading. Okay, when you double click on any line item, it is showing the details. What is my company code, what is my account group, what is the name, what is the post box number, what is recon account, what is short key, A1 plant group, 0001, like it's showing the details. You can double click on any line item, you can check your details is correct or not. Okay, and again convert data, execute, click click on your execute straight away. See this one, 10 means it is correct. Go back, display convert data. Okay, see this one, when it is showing green, it is the success. Okay, short key, click on account, country, post box, name, vendor group, company code, T code, table name, entire thing it's showing. Go back, then go back. Now click on your execute. Again click on your execute straight away. Don't do anything. Means batch input will be recorded. Now click on your execute. Select this. Click on your process session. Execute process session. Here, when you have large data, click on your background. When you have less data, click on process foreground. When you click on your background, it can be execute backend. When you click on your foreground, it can be execute in front of you. Even you can select display error only. In case of any errors, it go to display. So I'm showing, means I'm making the video for your display purpose. That is the reason I'm selecting foreground. Then click on your process. When you click on your foreground, press enter button in the keyboard. When it shows like this, press enter button in the keyboard. Enter, everything you just enter. In case of any error, it's showing. Press enter button in the keyboard, enter. Means I'm showing how it is happened here. Enter, press enter button in the keyboard. Enter. See this one? This is completed. It means we are successfully uploaded vendor masters. Do one thing. So open this one. This is the names, right? K and Co, K1 and Co, K2 and Co. This is the vendor names actually. Do one thing. Go to SAP. Go to SE16N. Enter here LFA1. What is the table name? LFA1. Click. Press enter button in the keyboard. Do one thing. Go to LFB1 company code level. Press enter. Here you can enter the company code. What is company code? FM01. This is the company code actually. This is the company code. FM01. Click on your execute. You can observe here that the vendors are uploaded or not. Wait. Go down. I thought vendor name should be shown on the LFA1. Wait, I will show you. So all are, this is the vendor numbers, this is the company code. See this one, what is the date? 24, right? See this one, this is the vendors I uploaded. 24. User, this is the recon account, this is the A1, 0001. See? In case you want to see the vendor names, go back, enter your LFA1, click on your and press enter. Straight away click on your execute. Here it shows all the vendors. Do one thing, you just filter here. Post box details 5000018. I'm filtering. Excuse me. Go down. Wait. Created on SAP user. User. Click on your execute. 24/04/2020. Click on your execute. See this one. This is the vendor number. This is the country. This is the names. K1, K2, K3, K4, K5. Different things. Post box number means I'm showing we are successfully uploaded the vendor master through LSMW. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe, share. In case of any queries, please comment in my comment box. In the future, I will make GL upload through LSMW. Okay, please follow my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. In case of any doubts, please comment in comment box.